plush toys. These are the most misunderstood and misused category of them all. Many owners buy these for their dogs and allow them to destroy them. Guys, this is wrong. Not only are you missing out on a tremendous learning opportunity, but you're also training your dog to tear apart other things they find, like slippers and wallets. A dog should never destroy one of these toys. In fact, a $1.99 plush toy should ostensibly last indefinitely. Your chew toys and interactive toys should get all the wear and tear. The plush toys are for teaching. A really good play and learning session I've used in the past uses an interactive toy and a plush toy. And it goes like this. The tug toy comes out first. The dog can't have it until we say, take it. And we play tug for a minute or so. This is a great time to teach game manners and rules like don't ever accidentally get me with your teeth. Now we use drop it. Teach it, re-instruct it, reinforce it. The tug toy goes away and the plush toy comes out. Here's where things get interesting. We squeak it and treat it like a baby in our hands. We treat it like it's alive. We want softness and kindness toward it. Any grab, bite, or tug gets a, hey, what have you done? You've hurt Mr. Toy. See, this is a violation of the take it rule. That is to say, the dog can't take it in her mouth unless and until we okay it. It also shows you the difference between what you think the boundaries are and what your dog thinks they are. Very often there's a disconnect there. This is where we step up and bridge that gap. If they grab for it or if their drop it is sloppy, then we have a 5-second instructive timeout in a downstay. Now the plush toy goes away and we repeat the cycle a few times. So the interactive toy comes out again and we use tug as a reward for being nice to the plush toy. Play this game between 5 and 10 minutes. When you're all done, say, all done, thank you, and put the toys away. Remember, access is restricted to these toys to only times when games are being played with you.